How long until the pirates are back in range?
Hour, maybe two, depending on burn. Same as last time.
The time before that.
And the tin time before that.
How are you doing?
I'm not the one we need to worry about.
Her body can't heal under this burn. Even Khan needs to rest sometime.
You'll figure something out. I know you will.
Motherfuckers! Shouldn't be possible! ETA, 8 minutes! They must have increased their burn this time.
Don't these Pashangwalas rest?
Humans rest. Pirates are fucking animals.
We need to do something about your arm. Virgil has the medbay prepped and ready.
It's fine. Hardly hurts anymore. We're outgunned and nearly out of fuel. Unless we come up with a plan to shake them soon, infection's gonna be the least of my problems.
What do you think we should do?
What do I think we should do? Besides find ourselves a captain who knows how to make decisions?
I was asking your opinion.
My opinion is that there is no good option. Whatever you choose will be wrong. And it's your fucking job to choose, Captain.
Coordinates, 8214. What are we looking at?
Fuck if I know.
It's a ship's graveyard. Debris field. Caught in orbit around that body.
There's nothing registered there.
How do you know?
Back when I was MCRN, there were reports of a proxy battle right around here with UNN forces. Never confirmed, but seemed legit.
Or much more likely, it's some solar backscatter, radiation cluttering, or any other fucking thing.
How large was this battle?
Large enough for a pissant ensign like me to hear about it. I'd guess nearly a dozen ships.
New plan. We run for cover in there.
Won't work, boss man. If we break their lock, they'll be able to track our drive plume.
There won't be a drive plume. We burn hard for here first, then cut engine and turn into orbit. Let it carry us around until we land in the debris.
Slingshot, fuck yes!
Could work, if there is actually something there.
Stations! Khan, on my word, loose a PDC volley, then turn and burn.
Landed in the debris field.
Ha 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 ha! It's shit pirates!
You did it, Barsmang! Fucking legend!
Quiet! We don't have much time. The pirates are searching for us, and we can't run again without more fuel and reaction mass. Arlen?
Baratna and I will head out and start scanning.
Captain, I'm prepped for surgery as soon as Khan is ready.
Tell that waste of oxygen I wouldn't be needing surgery if he didn't freak out the first time.
I'm still here.
Virgil's our doctor. He's what we have.
The prosthetic is ready. Is the, patient?
Fine. But you're staying to make sure Dr. Dipshit doesn't cut off the wrong arm.
Scanners aren't picking up any signs of fuel.
Keep looking. Meantime, I'll go for their reaction mass. What a mess. What got Earth and Mars so worked up?
And what's the Belter ship doing in the middle of it?
Who knows? Hopefully they all got some reaction mass on board, though.
Damn. The blast doors to the Laguin are locked down. Not sure if there's a way to open them.
Always a way through, if you got enough explosives. Go check out the other ships. I'll see what I can rig up.
You want to use explosives to blast through a blast door? Guess that could work.
Even tell which ship is which. It's all blasted to Falota.
There's definitely more scrap here than a few ships can account for. Maya was right. This was a full-on proxy battle.
With a Belter ship at the center.
The Martian ship had focus drugs on board. Must have wanted to question someone.
I hate those things. Rayon and I got busted by the MCR in once. Didn't think I'd leave that interrogation room alive.
Watching that Martian's eyes go all weird. Last time we ever stole anything on Vesta, had to move to Ceres and start stealing there.
Were they planning for an interrogation? Then why'd they start shooting? Found some reaction mass.
Toss it to me. I will store it. Nice toss, Cap! Woo!
Boss man, you probably noticed me Baratna's been a little edgy lately.
Ray, your brother has been an angry Pashangwalo since my first day on board.
This is different. He's got the shakes. It's the pixie dust. But he's been clean for almost a year. He takes some meds that help keep him straight, but...
But we haven't done a supply run in weeks.
Yeah, ran out of toxiperidone 3 days ago. Don't worry, boss man. He'll be fine. He's tough. But thought you should know.
Ugh. And Inyas say that Belta food is disgusting. Cox, I need you to tell me everything you know about this Toussaint and the Europa's Bay.
They're pirates, what's to tell?
Helpful as always. I'll leave you to enjoy the brig.
Wait. Is Kana... I mean... How is she?
She'll live. No thanks to you.
Or that hothead Virgil. He's the one who lunged in and made the gun go off.
Which was in response to you provoking him. You seem to say that he was hiding something from us.
Maybe. Let me out of here and we can talk about it.
No.
Real Earth whiskey. Even Cox has to settle for the Belta stuff.
Earthers love their oceans. Too bad they destroyed them all. Don't want to interrupt, but how is everything down there?
The auto dock kept us on track, but Virgil had to do some of the larger incisions himself. Khan will be out for a while. When she wakes up, we'll try to attach the prosthetic and... What the...
Oye, Maya. Shit. So the Belters stole some tech from the MCRN. That's how this started.
Then why did the UNN get involved?
Because they think they own the void. Had to throw their weight around once the Belters entered their territory.
Course they did.
Must be the captain. very proud of his connections to the UN and Brass.
Whatever the Belters stole, the UNN and MCRN both went after it.
But how did this turn into a shootout?
The MCRN overreacted to the theft, and the UNN overreacted to the Martian fleet. They got into a pissing contest, and neither backed down.
And the Belt got caught in the middle again.
Got a barrel here.
I'll take her. Good work, Sasata.
Boss Mang, I got everything hooked up to blow the door. Head back to the Laguin and check it out.
Got it. Hopefully we'll find enough reaction mass to get out of here.
And then what? We going treasure hunting?
Yeah. You think those coordinates go anywhere interesting?
We've been on the run for a week because somebody thinks so.
Think so with a lot of torpedoes and guns even.
Explosives are set.
Good work, Kamina. Now let the whole station see what happens to traitors who sell out the OPA to the Inyas.
I'm in. Another blast door.
Pshing. Fine, I'll get more explosives.
No need. I should be able to access the lockdown controls from the bridge.
Good thinking, Cap.
Could still find more explosives. Just in case.
Wouldn't let anyone get their hands on that tech. Good for them. I'll need to make a hole to pass this to the twins. Found another barrel.
This is loaded! Or whatever the Inyas say. Touchdown! Woo!
I've got some radiation from a nearby ship, the Manitoba. Scanner shows the engine is mostly intact. Maybe a few pellets too.
Boss man, that's the far edge of the debris field. You'll be exposed.
You two head back to the Artemis. Everyone stays on the ship, but be ready to pick me up on my order.
Captain, we're picking up a communication from the Europa's Bane.
Sabaka, they locked us?
No, it's a broadcast. But they must know we're close.
Patch it over.
There is no sense in running anymore. You know who I am, and I am looking forward to meeting you. Contact me to discuss the terms of your surrender. Or just sit and wait until we find you. It's only a matter of time.
Shit, shit, shit! Cap, you got to get back here!
Not without fuel pellets.
Stupid drone is stuck.
Sabaka? I doubt they will all be so easy to kill.
Virgil, if I respond, will they be able to trace the signal?
No, it will only confirm you are in broadcast range. But they seem pretty sure of that already.
Put me through. Captain Zapata, this is Kamina Drummer of the Artemis. I don't want to fight you, but keep sending your crew after me, and I'll be forced to keep killing them.
You're a long way from Ceres Station, Kamina Drummer.
You've heard of me?
I've heard of your work and your bounty. But if I'm speaking to you, what happened to Garrison Cox?
He attempted to double his profits. As a result, I am now captain.
Not surprising. There's no loyalty among scavengers.
Sabaka? I doubt they will all be so easy to kill.
Virgil, if I respond, will they be able to trace the signal?
No, it will only confirm you are in broadcast range. But they seem pretty sure of that already.
Put me through. Captain Zapata, this is Kamina Drummer of the Artemis. I don't want to fight you, but keep sending your crew after me, and I'll be forced to keep killing them.
A long way from Ceres Station, Kamina Drummer.
You've heard of me?
I've heard of your work and your bounty. But if I'm speaking to you, what happened to Garrison Cox?
He attempted to double his profits. As a result, I am now captain.
Not surprising. There's no loyalty among scavengers. Not that the OPA is any better. You must really enjoy the company of miscreants.
You can always retreat, Toussaint. Protect the rest of your crew.
Your reputation is well earned, Captain Drummer. Daniel and Yuri were... they were two of my best. But their needless deaths do not change.
Enough. I've had a very long week in a crash couch because of you. Either fall back or keep sending your men to die. Those are your options. Please tell me this thing has ammo.
I'm on my way.
No! Everyone, stay back! What's happening? Why are the pirates pulling away?
There are always more options, Captain. I'll have the coordinates. Even if I have to comb through rubble to find them. Goodbye.
You're bluffing. Hello? Toussaint! Come on. Gotta be some ammo left.
PDC delivery.
Tobacco. I told you to stay on the ship.
Reprimand me later. Just let me do my job now.
I don't know what the fuck you two are doing, but I'm approaching your location on control thrusters for whenever we shove off.
Glad you're back at your post.
What are you waiting for?
We only get one shot before they know opposition. There!
I believe celebrations are in order.
Coordinates are set for the MK core. Time to see what all the fucking fuss is about. With the fuel you found, we should have no problem getting there and back to Ganymede at least.
And how is the new prosthetic?
It'll do. Get some rest, Captain. No telling what we'll find at those coordinates.
Being captain isn't all fun and torpedoes. Sometimes, it means having to talk to Khan. Hey, Khan.
Resting. Go away.
(Clears
Can you believe how vicious these pirates are?
Yes.
I mean, how they were willing to blow us up just to prove a point.
Yes.
So you don't think there's anything special about them?
Yes, I do. They seem to have more guns.
Any guesses on our destination?
Nada. All I know is that it's far the fuck out there. So whoever hid that treasure wanted it far the fuck away.
Good talking to you, Khan.
Yeah.
It's been a rough week. I should check in with the crew and see how everyone's doing. I suppose this is what downtime looks like for Maya.
Hey, Cap.
What are you listening to?
It's Martian music. You wouldn't like it.
You're right. I can't stand that twangy acoustic for Lota.
Typical closed-minded belter. If you change your mind, you can give it a listen.
Khan seemed pleased with her prosthetic.
That's good. Although you realize we just took the most unhinged person on the ship and gave her a bionic skull crusher for an arm.
I think if Khan wanted to kill someone, she could do it without arms or legs.
What you did in the debris field was incredibly reckless. You disobeyed my order, and you put the whole...
Oh my god. You're fucking welcome.
I was getting to that. Thank you.
Anytime.
I'll leave you to it, then.
Wait. About that moment in the airlock.
Yes?
Are you feeling any better? I know you were pretty scared, given how tightly you were holding my hand.
I noticed how terrified you were. Must have been your first time facing real danger.
And my first time comforting my terrified captain. I'm here if you need to talk, by the way.
The only thing we need to talk about is your delusion of fantasizing about me.
I get it. It must be hard for the Boss Meng to express her feelings. Especially to the hot Martian engineer who can totally kick your ass.
Not according to that scoreboard.
My point is, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. Hmm. Even if you did clink helmets with me.
Clink helmets? What is that supposed to mean?
I think you know exactly what it means. Helmet clinker.
Let's pretend for a moment that we did touch helmets. So what? You're clearly obsessing over such an insignificant moment. It's sad.
Bullshit. From the look in your eyes, I would have thought helmet clinking was Belter third base. You know, we could stand here talking about hands and helmets all night. Or we could go back to my room and settle it.
I'm confused. Are you still trying to fight me?
Either way, someone will definitely be getting slammed against a wall.
Falota! Maya's the one who stole Khan's barbecue sauce. That is, not at all surprising, actually. Honestly, I'm glad Maya finally got one. This was starting to get sad. Arlen treats Rayan like he's the weak one, but I haven't heard a single complaint from Rayan since his surgery. Maya and Virgil learned a lot of Langbelta swear words in the past week. Khan seems to already know them all. Whatever Cox was saying about Virgil's past clearly upset him. I need to know what it was about.
What's on your mind, Captain?
Cox said you were hiding something. Something that Belters wouldn't like.
Cox is a habitual liar. First, he tried to murder you. Then he tried to deflect blame onto me.
So there's nothing else you wish to share? Nothing you're hiding?
No, Captain. No more than anyone else on this ship.
Get some rest, Virgil.
Will do, Captain.
Whoever took Khan's barbecue sauce is a lot braver or stupider than I am. If I sleep with Maya, the entire crew will know about it. Nothing stays secret on a ship like this. Is one night worth all the drama? Sorry, Maya.
Go to sleep, Captain.
Pashang, are you watching me?
No. Now sleep.
Nothing on the map. No record of any settlements. So what the fuck is that?